Hello, everyone. I am Amanda from AmandaRightNow.com. I teach 8th grade English in the Bay Area, and I help teachers understand how to implement reading and writing workshop in their classroom and how I feel these methods of teaching reading and writing are so simple and like save us so much time and are just the most engaging way and best way to help students feel like what they're doing in your class is relevant and meaningful and is helping them build habits as readers and writers, because I feel like that's the ultimate goal of an English teacher and all teachers for that matter, helping students develop identities as readers and writers. So today I want to talk about planning a whole class novel unit, and feel free in the comments to introduce yourself and ask me any questions you would like during this Facebook Live. So, and the reason I'm talking about this is because I just finished writing a whole class novel unit, but it's also a unit that you can use while also implementing reading workshop, because I do believe that you can do both. I do believe you can teach a whole class novel and continue to allow your students to pick books that they enjoy reading, especially the more advanced readers in your classroom. They could finish a whole class novel in a week and then be ready to read their own individual choice books earlier than other students in your class. And so just like allowing for that. And my last Facebook Live was all about that, like teaching whole class novels and reading workshop at the same time. But this Facebook Live is all about just planning a whole class novel unit. And so I have 7 steps to talk to you about today. And if you're interested in my new unit, I'll put a link to it in the comments. My workshop teacher members received this unit on November 1st, but I also put it in my Teachers Pay Teachers store. It's a little more expensive on my Teachers Pay Teachers store than if you join as a member, and members get a lot of benefits like being in a Facebook group, being able to email me questions that they have and interact with me, and we have meetings every month, and so it's really fun. I'm working really hard to build a community of teachers who love using the workshop method and want to simplify their lives and want to connect and want to really make reading and writing meaningful in their classrooms. So it's pretty exciting. I have over 100 members, and currently it's closed, but if you want to join the waitlist, I'll put a link to that too in the comments. Okay, so 7 things that you need to do to plan your whole class novel unit. So the first thing, and I believe is the most important thing, is decide on the purpose. You know, like I feel like a lot of us at our schools, we have all these copies of this one book, and it's like, okay, we're going to read this book, and that's the purpose. We're all going to read this book together. And it's like, no, I feel like there needs to be some reason, you know, some essential standards that you really want your students to demonstrate at the end of the unit or throughout the unit, or you want some sort of the students to practice some sort of skills. And so I'm going to give you actually a list of possible purposes for reading a whole class novel. And the purpose should also be tied to the culminating event. So what happens at the end of reading the novel? And so I'm going to give you some purposes and some examples of culminating events at the end of a whole class novel unit. And I do think that we should be thinking about the purpose and the culminating event at the beginning when we first start planning our unit, so that we have, you know, we have like a map, or we have a destination that we know we're trying to get to through the novel. And it also, I think, depends on the novel you're reading too. So that's the second step, is picking an engaging book. And some of us don't really get to pick. You know, we just have these copies of these books in our library, and that's the book that we're kind of stuck with. But you can always, you know, do like a Donors Choose grant to get copies of other types of books as well that you would more enjoy reading. Okay, so what would be the purpose behind a whole class novel unit? So one purpose could be that students are participating in some sort of discussion event at the end, But I would recommend that they discuss throughout the entire unit. So there's practice discussions built in. And then the last discussion, when everyone is supposed to have finished the book, should be the one that's assessed. And there's multiple ways to run discussions. So three ways that I think are wonderful are, I think all of us are pretty familiar with the Socratic seminar method. And if you're not, you know, you can Google it, and there's so much information about Socratic seminars and how to run them. But I feel like instead of having one Socratic seminar, a whole class novel, you should have multiple. Students should have multiple opportunities to practice the skills, the discussion skills of a Socratic seminar, not just one, and like be assessed on just one discussion day, you know? So just having multiple opportunities for them to practice. And the unit that I wrote has multiple discussion days. There's this other method that I learned pretty recently called the TQE method, which is thoughts, questions, epiphanies, and it's really neat. I love this method of teaching discussion skills. So it involves small group discussions where students have a little bit of time to meet in small groups and develop questions and that they really want to talk about as a whole class. They write those questions on the board, and then you have a whole class discussion, which is really cool. And then there's this other method that my friend Betsy Potash from Now Spark Creativity has introduced me to, and I'm really excited about it, called the Harkness method. And I've never tried Harkness, but it sounds really, really neat and engaging for students. And it's very hands-off. Like, the teacher is very much just an observer, and the students take charge, and they take leadership over the discussion. So, you know, I feel like whole class novels, one of the best reasons to read a whole class novel is to develop students' discussion skills. But another reason you might want, like, purpose behind reading a whole class novel would be annotating and learning how to interact with literature and how to think about literature and respond to literature through writing. And I love having students throughout a unit learn different ways that they can interact with literature. And those become my mini lessons. And those, when students write on post-its, like, and I'll talk about the different types of ways that they can interact with literature and respond to literature. When they do that, then they're writing, and they can take what their response is to the discussion. So they're prepared for the discussion. So while they're reading, they're responding through writing somehow. So that could be another good purpose for reading a whole class novel. You could also have students write a literary essay at the end of a whole class novel unit. But I feel like if you're going to do that, you really want to teach the literary essay, you know, collecting evidence for a literary essay, trying to determine the theme, and trying to determine some sort of big idea about a character as they're reading the novel, so that you're building them up to write that essay at the end. So then your mini lessons aren't going to be so much directed towards discussion skills and responding to literature skills, but more directed towards how can I collect evidence and build big ideas as I'm reading this novel in preparation for writing a literary essay. So that might be the purpose behind your whole class novel. Another reason might be for them to give their opinions of the book and write a book review on, like, Goodreads. So they're kind of analyzing it and arguing about it with their classmates, possibly. You could also have them investigate author's craft and then write a letter to the author about what they noticed and ask the author questions and things like that. So there's all sorts of really awesome things you can do when reading a whole class novel, and like, why would we read a whole class novel? So figuring out your purpose and your culminating event, I think, is the first step. The second step is choosing an engaging book that's at the reading level of your students. And I think a lot of teachers, they only have access to books, like classic books, that are pretty advanced for some of our students. And so figuring out like what is the Lexile level of this book and what is the Lexile level of my students, and understanding that if the Lexile level of your book is higher than the Lexile level of some of your students, like, you're going to have to provide supplements for those students. You're going to have to provide, you know, spark notes for those students or audio versions of the book for those students. And trying to pick a book, I think that historical fiction is a genre that students typically don't pick themselves, and classics. So picking a book that students wouldn't necessarily choose on their own, and a book that's engaging and that might interest the majority of your students and has topics that are relatable. So picking an engaging book is the next step when planning your whole class novel unit. The next step is making a reading schedule, coming up with a calendar and having your students fill in the calendar with the page numbers they need to read to by specific dates, especially if you're planning on having different discussions throughout the unit. You're gonna wanna have, you know, little markers, you know, by Friday be to this page, by this Friday be to this page, be ready to discuss up to this point and things like that. And I'm also a big fan of allowing students to read ahead, but also giving them time to review what's being discussed on the day that you have the discussion, if that's the purpose of your whole class novel, giving them time to review those pages so they don't reveal any spoilers for the other kids if they're reading ahead. So making some sort of schedule and showing it to students and giving students ownership of that schedule and having them figure out like, okay, what times am I going to read each day? Am I going to read an hour every other day? Am I going to read 30 minutes every single day? Am I just going to read, you know, a whole bunch on Saturday? And like have students think about their habits and their life outside of school and having them figure out like how they're going to build in that reading time into their life. But also, if you're doing reading workshop, you should be building in reading time during the work time portion of workshop. So you teach your mini lesson, and then the rest of the period is allowing students to read the whole class novel and you having conferences during that work time. So make a schedule, give it to students so that they know the deadlines, right? That's important. And then deciding on the mini lessons that you want to teach. So and this depends on the purpose of your unit, right? So if you're teaching students discussion skills, then you're going to want to teach students how to have meaningful discussions. And in the unit that I just released, I have all sorts of really great tools and posters, and they're editable to teach students how to have meaningful discussions in small groups and in a larger group setting. And I teach students basic discussion skills and advanced discussion skills. And I love to teach students how to respond to literature. So there's really basic ways of responding to literature, like making connections, summarizing parts of the book, predicting, but there's more advanced skills like noticing author's craft moves and noticing character development, noticing figurative language. Teaching those kinds of things in mini lessons and modeling reading parts of your novel and writing about what you're noticing as the character's developing, or noticing like clues about the theme. So analyzing theme while you're writing. So, you know, decide on what mini lessons your students most need. And you can base this off of, you know, certain tests that, like, if you give like a STAR test, or base these off of the assessments that your school gives. If whatever assessment your school has. Our school used to do SRI and now we do STAR, and we have like STAR has a lot more detail about what our students are struggling with and what kind of instruction they need. So developing your mini lessons based on those assessments can be really, really powerful. And then the fifth thing that you need to do when you're planning is make time for conferring. Make time the, you know, create a roster, list the skills at the top. You know, comprehension should be like a basic skill that you're checking in with students on their comprehension of the novel. And so having conversations while students are reading their novel during work time and checking in with them and help and summarizing parts and asking them if they have questions and, you know, really helping them with comprehension. And then also those more advanced skills like noticing author's craft moves and finding evidence of a particular theme and noticing character development and things like that. So, you know, having conferences, knowing your kids' Lexile levels and which kids you really need to check in with during the conferences. And then also the sixth thing that you definitely need to, you know, plan for in your whole class novel unit is allowing students time to just write long about the novel. Give them prompts to write about, you know, and have them practice writing about the novel before discussing the novel in small groups, writing questions that they have, teaching them the difference between, you know, a closed question and an open question. And closed questions are just as important as open questions. Closed questions are like comprehension questions. You know, you can find the answer really quickly in a book, whereas open questions are more debatable, like good juicy discussion questions. And so having students write questions and then answer them, you know, like, so my last thing you need to plan for in your whole class novel unit is allowing students to write about their thoughts and their opinions and their questions involving the novel. Okay, and then I want to end with just showing you kind of my unit at a glance planning calendar. So I'm going to try and I'm going to share my screen with you so that you can see this whole class novel unit. So this is the unit, and there I have a unit at a glance, which is really cool. And so I just want to show this to you so you can kind of see how I plan my whole class novel unit. So start with the results. What do you want students to be able to do by the end of the unit? What evidence are you going to have? What learning experiences are you going to give students during your whole class novel unit? And then this is just a calendar, okay? So this is the mini lesson I'm teaching. This is the goal. These are the materials. This is these are the choices students have during work time. This is how I'm closing the day, the period. Okay, so Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and then here's the next week, and then the next week, and then the next week. So pretty simple planning. I love planning digitally because these are links to different tools that I can use for my lessons. If you want this, I will put a link to the whole class novel reading workshop unit in the comments. And yeah, feel free to ask me any questions about planning a whole class novel unit. I love experiencing novels with my students and listening to them discuss and give their opinions and thoughts about books. It's pretty fun. So thank you for watching, and I will see you again next Tuesday. I come on every Tuesday, so I really, I love doing this. And thanks for joining me, everyone.